lethal discretion. It was an extraordinary act of violence. And the mere fact that he was young simply does not excuse that conduct. Although we're aware of his age and certainly had that in that played a role in our assessment of the facts and the case.
We had a number of statements in court that I thought were interesting, including his intent wasn't to kill you. What led you to make those kind of statements?
Well, I think, you know, sentencing is a chance for the community and for the court to really understand the essence of the case and understand why we're here. And there's been a lot of discussion during the course of this case and during the 4 years it's been in front of the public and in the court system about the FBI and about the facts at a large scale, 1,000-foot level. But really the essence of this case is one man's choice to kill as many people as possible. And it's painful for a lot of people to have to confront that and to have to see it for what it is, which is an extraordinary choice, a rare choice, and one that we want to try and avoid happening again. And so our attempt today and our effort today was to try and make that clear to the public and to the court. All right. Thanks, Bob.
I
recognized you,
To come by and say hi at some point, you know, I know why we saw the case.
Absolutely. No, I've seen your name in connection with some of the stuff. So,
you know, at some point later on,
what I would say to that, I mean, that really goes along with the argument that was made by the defense about the imperfect entrapment mitigation. And just to